Telesto. The very name of it strikes fear into the hearts of players and Bungie developers alike. Its reign of terror over the course of Destiny 2 history is a varied tale, full of game-breaking bugs that never seem to stop. Not only was it very meta in PvP for a time, but just about every update Destiny gets, another Telesto bug surfaces. What gives? Why does this one exotic fusion rifle break the game so hard? Today, we'll be looking at the history of Telesto's bugs in Destiny 2 and how it's broken the game so many times. So let's first jump into why this gun functions differently from other fusion rifles. See, Telesto doesn't act like a normal fusion rifle. Telesto's energy bolts stick to surfaces and players for a short time before detonating, while all other fusion rifles fire with hit scan bolts which immediately disappear when they hit a surface or a player. The game classifies Telesto's bolts as entities, which is what causes these constant issues and bugs. It's believed that the bolts are coded as such in order to properly function, detonate, and have a short lifetime. Now, the problem with the bolts being considered entities is that it interferes with many other things in the game that interact or have to do with entities. You'll see what I mean here in a second. Let's take a look at the first major Telesto bug. A couple weeks into the Forsaken expansion, the Blindwell activity launched. It was a straightforward activity, capture plates by killing enemies and fight bosses. Shortly after its launch, one Redditor by the name of ItsOshi discovered that Telesto could be used to progress the Blindwell almost instantly. In his post on Reddit, he details that when you shoot the gun at the floor, and when the bolts explode, each individual bolt would count as an enemy defeated, thus adding progress towards the plate capture. Naturally, the entire community flocked to this activity with their Telestos, allowing each wave of the Blindwell to be completed almost instantly. Bungie patched that one up pretty quick, but it set the precedent of, if this gun shoots entities, won't that bug out other stuff? This was only the beginning. We had no idea what was to come. It's the season of opulence, and our good frenemy Emperor Kallus has just opened up the menagerie to all players. It features some cool new encounters, and most importantly, a rehash of the Gauntlet encounter from the Leviathan raid. At the end of the Gauntlet, there's a finish line that requires players to cross it to add to completion. Well, what if instead of crossing it, you shot it multiple times with Telesto? Yep, Bungie didn't fix Telesto previously, they just fixed the Blindwell instead. So the sticky entities it shoots were still classified as entities, and when they were fired at the finish line, it counted for completion in the Gauntlet. In fact, because of how many entities it shoots over the course of a couple shots, it would instantly complete the encounter and give you the flawless triumph for your entire team not dying in the Gauntlet. So yeah, another fun Telesto entity bug, and definitely not the last either. Fun fact, suiciding in the finish line, or shooting other sticky weapons like Prospector would also count towards completion too. Weird. It had been a whole season since the Gauntlet glitch. The Year 3 Shadowkeep expansion dropped, and no bugs had been found yet. However, Telesto had been biding its time, waiting to spring out with another bug, and this one was the most broken yet. While the other bugs just affected some player versus enemy activities, this one would affect every mode, including the Crucible.
Actually full super. I just used it. Imagine.
Oh my god.
Imagine. No worry.
13 body damage. 32.
All right, here.
Super weak super, by the way.
Streamer Chadlantis TV discovered this bug and made it widely known. Essentially, with an Ashes to Assets mod equipped, you could shoot some Telesto bolts into the ground, throw a grenade at it, and instantly get your super. While this worked in any activity, it was most concerning in the Crucible, where you had a huge advantage over other players off the bat. Some context. Ashes to Assets is a class item mod that gives you an amount of super energy for killing an enemy with a grenade. The grenade exploding would kill the Telesto entities and grant you super energy. Bungie disabled the gun almost immediately. A fun side note, a player had Telesto equipped when Bungie disabled it, and they found that it bugged out their secondary slot and affected other weapon scopes. Not a serious bug by any means, but a cool look at how the game uses scopes. At this point, three major incidents with Telesto had come and gone. Surely, Bungie would fix the gun itself, and not patch what it affects, right? The second season in Year 3, Season of Dawn, introduced obelisk mods, which could be used to give players new perks on their armor. Reddit user The Awesome Potato alerted the community that one of the new mods called Heavy Handed could be exploited by the infamous Telesto. The secondary perk on the mod states that when you're surrounded by multiple enemies, defeating an enemy with a fusion rifle, shotgun, sidearm, or submachine gun adds ammo for that weapon to your reserves. See the word fusion rifle right there? Telesto is a fusion rifle. All you had to do was stand near enemies, shoot Telesto on the ground, and each bolt that detonated would count as an enemy killed. Basically, infinite ammo. Thanks, Bungie. We've seen the major bugs, but let's take a look at some of the smaller bugs that Telesto also caused. First, did you know that Telesto can destroy the injection rig vents even when they're closed? Second, who can forget shooting your teammate with Telesto, sticking them with it, and having them jump at Kallus to do big damage? Third, you could shoot Telesto at a friendly Titan bubble to send all the projectiles into the very middle. If any enemies entered the bubble, they'd die almost instantly. Despite all these bugs that continue to be discovered, Bungie has not fixed the gun itself. Maybe it's too much effort to rework the gun, or changing it from shooting entities would make it not function like it's supposed to. It seems almost anything in the game that has to do with enemies dying or entities interacting with things will allow Telesto to exploit it. Until they completely fix it, bugs with Telesto will continue to occur. It's been really fun to follow these bugs as they drop, and I for one am excited to see when the next Blind Well or Ashes to Assets bug occurs. Nothing is more fun than waking up and seeing a Reddit post titled, "Another Telesto Bug." God bless Bungie and their spaghetti code. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time Telesto decides to break the game.